the brow, start the wing, let's see how she does.
It's been a wonderful season, a very busy season, and there's been a lot going on. Even though it's a lot less makeup, still a lot of interesting new ideas when it comes to makeup.
It's got a very modern feel. There's not tons of lashes, there's not tons of shading. It's very, you know, raw.
The mood of spring 2015, there was a lot of raw glamour. I mean, for me, it was in a way a raw glamour, but a realness. It was very real. It was quite a rock and roll look as well, whether from Anna Sui, a little bit of glitter on the eye, or whether it be a really strong dark eyebrow, or even if it's a dark eye, everything's simplified. People just wanted makeup that looked different. So you were challenged into doing something not only minimal, but also into doing something that was out of the box, new.
So we're backstage at Stella McCartney, and the foundations and concealers that are applied are very natural, only where they need it. And then just before they go on the runway, we're gonna apply some moisturizer, maybe even a little bit of an oily cream just to highlight the cheekbones. But it is a very fresh and healthy, glowing skin.
To achieve incredible, glowing skin that we did at so many shows, a lot of the time I found myself putting the foundation on and actually taking it off certain areas so that there was a certain rawness, a realness. So it was never about coating the face with foundation. It was always about putting the foundation in certain areas only, but keeping the cheeks alive and keeping the cheeks bare. But it was almost like using your foundation as a moisturizer. It's about perfect skin. The backstage at Lanzana, and the look, it's all about natural makeup in a way again. Nude lips, eyebrows groomed, makeup foundation where needed. Albert wanted the girls just to be chic and beautiful and who they are, and much more simplified beauty. There were many different types of smoky eyes. Cavalli was much more of a metallic smoky eye with a little bit of a bronze to it. And then also we did smoky eyes just done with a pencil, a mascara and one eyeshadow. So very simple eye, almost that you could, you know, do your eye while you were in the back of a cab, rather than, you know, have to be a real artist. Just a simpler way of approaching makeup. A much more easier way. It was real, but also slightly rebellious.
We're backstage at the Roberto Cavalli show. Took some of the MaxFactor excess shimmer in Onyx just around the edges of the eye and on the outer corners, all blended. So it's a mix of rich browns, coffees, and silvers.
Most of the makeup this season looks as if you could almost do it yourself. It's like a one step to perfection, almost. So whether it be sparkle on the eye, it's not perfectly applied.
So we're backstage at Anna Sui. We use two colours, gold and pink, and it's glitter. And it looks great. The girls love it. It's very easy to wear. They're having a lot of fun. Everything's bare.
Very exciting season for eyeliners.
It's a very much a mix of time periods, isn't it? You can see the influence of every time period in it, but definitely it all started with that very sharp wing and the fact that it's not ladylike. It had to be tough.
There was a lot of playing with eyeliners and half eyeliners, mini wings, eyeliners in the brow. It was manga-inspired eyeliners. It's quite kind of like a futuristic punk eyeliner in a way. When you look at the richness in the fabrics and the clothing, I think that you need a simpler face. I think it looks younger, I think it looks fresher, and I think that's where the designers are coming from. For this season, there was such a trend on the girls being quite rebellious. She was very fierce, very strong woman this season. I think that was something that ran through all the collections, that war glamour, a real rock and roll spirit, real individualism this season. So I think that's all part of the whole movement of what was going on.